Ugh, the things I watch for you guys. I was expecting to like Leprechaun 4 in space. The director of the third film returns to direct it, which gave me high hopes instantly. Also, the idea is so stupid that how could they really fuck it up? Well, somehow they managed. Leprechaun 4 is flat out awful. Not a single redeemable quality whatsoever anywhere in the film. Everything they could possibly do wrong, they do wrong. We never actually find out when the film is set or even how the Leprechaun got into space, which is the first problem I have with the film. In other space horror sequels such as Critters 4 and Jason X, they actually explained how they got into space. In this one, they didn't, and it annoyed the shit out of me. The film starts off on a spaceship using the worst CGI I have ever seen in my life. But hey, the film's from 1997, which I've said many times before is the absolute worst year for CGI ever. On the spaceship, there are a group of space marines who are on a search and destroy mission to kill the Leprechaun. Meanwhile, the Leprechaun is trying to wed an alien princess called Zarina so that he can become the king of her home planet. She surprisingly agrees, but the space marines come in, kill the Leprechaun and save her. But before leaving the planet, a space marine starts to piss on the Leprechaun's corpse. Remember this because it's important later. The two main characters of the movie are the ship's biological officer Tina and a marine known as Books. They share a lot of scenes together where it's obvious they're trying to make the two become a couple, but they share no chemistry whatsoever, so it's really awkward. The marine who pissed on the Leprechaun corpse then is about to get lucky with another marine. However, when he gets aroused, he starts to feel loads of pain. Then the Leprechaun rips himself out of the marine's genitals. Yep. That happens. Imagine the chest burster scene from Alien, but instead of bursting out the person's chest, it bursts out the person's penis. The Leprechaun then starts trying to kill off all the crew members on the ship. At the same time, a half-robotic scientist known as Dr. Mittenhand is using Zarina the Princess's blood to regenerate himself since she has regenerative powers. This plot thread goes nowhere, so it doesn't really have much of a point. Except for the one scene where the Leprechaun blends a spider and a scorpion into the blood, turning Dr. Mittenhand into a giant spider. This scene also has no purpose. There is one fight scene at the end between Dr. Mitten's spider, yep, they actually call him that, and Tina, but it's over very shortly. I've seen many flawed movies in the 3 years since I started making horror movie reviews, but I've never seen one that has had so little effort or enthusiasm put into it like Leprechaun 4. It's obvious no one wanted to make the movie. Nothing is good in it. The film is stupid and incredibly unoriginal. There are many times where they rip off much better films. They rip off Alien surprisingly a lot in the film. They even shamelessly rip off Star Wars in one of the early scenes. The special effects are absolutely atrocious. I think I can honestly say that this film has the worst CGI effects I have ever seen in any movie ever made. It's just awful, flat out, atrocious. The effects look like the absolute worst low-budget sci-fi show from the mid-90s imaginable. There is a scene where the Leprechaun grows in size that is almost laughably bad. The picture quality of the Leprechaun is really pixelated and horrible. It's obvious they've just taken a shot of him really quite far away and then blown it up to a huge size. The sets all look awful. In the battle in the beginning of the film, you see loads of rocks and stuff that look like they were taken from a child's play area. It's awful. A lot of the sets on the ship shamelessly rip off Alien. The technology is very Alien-esque, and the bright usage of the color white is the same also. The acting is awful. Nobody tries in the film. Some people seem like they're kind of trying, but I'm not sure. For example, Tina, who is played by Jessica Collins, is okay, but nothing special. Fans of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia will probably recognize her as the news reporter in the episode all about the huge storm that is coming. Sadly, Warwick Davis is barely in the film, but when he isn't very good, which is weird because he was actually really good in the first three movies. A lot of the film tries to act like a straight movie. There are about four or five jokes in the movie, or at least from what I could tell. I laughed at one of them, probably because I was desperately trying to find something at least a little bit funny in the film. The kills are not very good either. In fact, barely anyone dies in the movie, and when they do, there is no blood or gore whatsoever. I did not expect Leprechaun 4 in Space to be good, but I at least expected it to be a stupid yet fun movie like the first and third movie. But somehow they just completely fucked everything up, creating one of the most uncomfortable and boring movie experiences I've had in a long time. At least a lot of the bad movies I review on this show are so bad that they're kind of funny and I find a lot to make fun of about it, but this is just flat out bland and boring. Even if you're curious, don't watch this film. You'll just be wasting your time. I give Leprechaun 4 in Space a 0.5 out of 10.